हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन सेशन फॉर द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल सेफ्टी। दिस इज आवर वर्चुअल क्लासेस एंड बाय दिस वी कैन हैव अ ब्रीफ डिस्कशन ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट। सब्जेक्ट इज मेनली फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ स्ट्रक्चरल इंजीनियरिंग एंड मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग। सो दिस इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सब्जेक्ट एंड होप यू फाइंड इट मच मोर इंटरेस्टिंग। वी विल डिस्कस इन अ ब्रीफ, we will have a practical application of the topics and let's start with our session. So 1 2 3 go. Hello students, welcome to the online session for the subject of industrial safety. So this is a session that is mainly for the students of the structural engineering and mechanical engineering, because both the students of this stream are mainly working in the industries. Their work may be either regarding the design of machines, equipments in the industry, or for the construction of the sheds and the infrastructure of the industry. So both the students of structural engineering and mechanical engineering are working in the industry, so for them it is very much required to study this subject. So let's start the session, and here we are going to have a glimpse of the syllabus of the industrial safety subject. So let's start with our subject. So here the figure only says that a large scale industry is there, and because of some reason an accident has occurred, and accident is a major accident. So fumes of fires are being coming out from this industry. So this is a major accident, a major hazard has occurred because of any kind of a problem. The problem can be either electrical problem or the mechanical problem, so or any other kind of a fault that has been occurred, either leakage of the gas from the cylinders or sparkling because of the movement of the machine, or the sparkling that has also caused because of the abrasion, extra abrasion or more friction that has occurred. So a small spark or any kind of a small problem has caused this mega disaster. So this mega disaster has caused the deaths of number of workers that are working in the industry. So ultimately the workers have lost their lives, many of the workers have got injured because of this accident. So it is very much necessary to prevent such kind of hazard, because it will be causing the deaths of the worker, and not only regarding to the life of the worker, but also it will cause a financial loss to the owner of the industry. The owner have faced the problem for the, regarding the debt. His work has got stopped, so he will not get the money for the continuation of the work. So this is a problem regarding the financial point of view, and also the problem can occur from the psychological point of view. Because the work has stopped, and till the problem is not being rectified or the overall infrastructure of the industry is not being set up again, till that no work will be done in the industry. Ultimately he will not earn money till that date. So it is both psychological and financial problem to the owner, and parallelly number of workers have lost their lives and number of workers have lost their many problems has faced, not only losing but also the injuries are also occurred. So these are all the things that are being occurring because of these hazards. So why this hazard has occurred, what is the reason, how we can prevent it, that all thing will be discussing in this subject. And each and every component of the industry we will be discussing, and how to deal with that component, how to deal with that problem will be discussed in this subject of the industrial safety. So moving towards our syllabus, our mainly the syllabus consists of 5 components, and that is mainly divided into 5 components. That is the industrial safety, then wear and corrosion and the prevention method, then fault tracing, then periodic maintenance and fundamental maintenance. So these are all the things that are included in the syllabus. So moving towards our first module, that is industrial safety. So industrial safety is why we need the industrial safety. So major reason is to prevent it from the major hazards and major accidents. So for that purpose, all the things are required to be understood, and all the things that is required to be understood at the early initial stage of the industrial engineer will be discussed in this session. Those things will be nothing but the definitions of the hazards, definition of the accidents, what are the causes of the hazards, how it is being created, whether it is an electrical fault or the mechanical fault. So, and also the hazards or accidents that is being caused because of the mechanical fault will be also discussed. The problems that has been caused because of the electrical fault will be also discussed. What are the measures to prevent such kind of accidents and hazards will be also discussed. So we will be discussing all those topics. Parallelly, we are going to discuss the silent features of the Factory Act 1948. So all the things that are included in that act, Factory Act of 1948, will be discussed in this module number 1. So yes, these are all the topics. Now moving towards our next module, that is fundamental of the maintenance engineering. So in fundamental of the maintenance engineering, we are going to discuss the definition of the maintenance. We are going to discuss the concept of the maintenance. We are going to discuss the need of the maintenance engineering in the industry. So with the help of that, we can come to know what is the role of a maintenance in an industry. We will be also discussing the role of the maintenance department. Parallelly, we are also going to discuss what are the tools that are being used for the daily maintenance of the machines and other equipments in the industry, whether it is a motor operated or hydraulically operated or electrically operated. All these tools we are going to discuss in this session of the particular in module number 2. We are also going to discuss the service life of the equipment, and we will be calculating the service life of the equipment in this session. So these are all the topics that we are going to discuss in module number 2. Now moving towards our third module, that is wear and corrosion and their prevention. So in this module, we are going to deal with the wear and the corrosion. We all know that wear is nothing but the change in the shape and size because of the daily usage of the equipment. And corrosion is nothing but an oxidation. We all know that the components of the machines are exposed to the atmosphere. So because of that, the oxidation used to take place, and ultimately the corrosion will be taking place. So in this module, we are going to define wear, corrosion, what are the types of the wears, what are the types of corrosion, what are the methods with the help of which this corrosion and the wear will be prevented. So all the things we are going to discuss in the module number 3. Now moving towards module number 4, that is the fault tracing. So in this, we are going to deal with a fault. We are going to trace a fault. Particularly, we are going to find the details of that fault. For example, where that fault has occurred, when that fault has occurred, why this fault has occurred, and what is the reason behind occurrence of this fault. So that at the early age of this fault, we can trace it, we can prevent it to occur, or we can say that we can prevent the increase in the intensity of the fault. So ultimately, we can prevent our industry from a major hazard. So these are all the things that we are going to discuss in this fault tracing method. There we are also going to discuss the concept of the fault tracing. What is the sequence of the fault tracing? We are also going to discuss the design tree concept. We are going to draw the design tree concept of various equipments. For example, engines, electric motors, then other equipments, other machines, of all the elements, we are going to design the fault tracing technique. So this is what is there in our module number 4. So by this, we can catch the fault at the early age, and we can prevent the occurrence of the major hazards. Now moving towards our last module, that is periodic and preventive maintenance. So there we are going to discuss the concept of the periodic maintenance. We are going to discuss what is the need of the periodic maintenance. We are also going to discuss why we need a periodic maintenance. So all the things we are going to discuss in this module number 5. We are also going to discuss different methods. For example, degreasing, cleaning, fitting of the bolts. All the things we are going to discuss in this. Parallelly, we are also going to discuss the problem of overhauling. How the overhauling on the machines, on the electric motors, on the engines and other equipment, if they are being overhauled, then what will be their behavior? We will be discussing in this module number 5. How they will behave, there we are also going to discuss. And ultimately, a solution for their overhauling problem will be also found in this module number 5. So by this, we can get a safe equipment, we can get the reliable equipment, and long working equipment we can get. So by this, it will be helpful to our industry, it will be helpful to the workers, because the long life equipment will be very much beneficial to the owner, because they will not need to invest money periodically for that equipment. And if the machine is running properly, then worker will find ease of working with that machine. They will feel ease of working with that machine. So ultimately, the machines will be reliable, they will be safe, they will be long lasting, they will be reliable. So all the things will be beneficial to the workers also and the owner also. And ultimately, the productivity of the industry will be increased, and more the profits will be earned, and owner will get the benefits of all the things. And parallelly, the lives of the workers will be also be safe. So this is why we are dealing with the periodic maintenance. So these are all the things we are going to discuss in the subject of industrial safety. The syllabus is completely discussed, and thanks for attending this session. See you in the next session, where we will be starting our syllabus. Thank you. So students, thank you for attending my session. Hope you have discussed a lot. And if you have any kind of a doubts, any kind of a queries, you can send me your doubts and queries through mail. My mail ID is in my channel. So do see it, do send me the mails. Do you like to send me your comments? And thanks for attending the session again. See you in the next session. Thank you.